Good afternoon, students. In today's lecture, we will study ICT and computer models that are used in agriculture. Let's study with the topic of ICT. ICT in agriculture. ICT innovation plays a key role in improving agricultural production and value chain. Food traceability system using ICT have become very important risk management tools that allow food business operator or authorities to contain food safety problem and promote consumer confidence. Then is ICT enabled marketing and access to markets play major role, especially for information on market prices and demand. ICT enhanced marketing and certification strengthen the capacity of small scale producer to increase revenue by improving their positions on local and international market. Let's discuss what is ICT mean. ICT is information communication technology. As the word is information and communication is concerned, information means the digit and communication means the digital technology. That means digital technology where we are using over smart devices or computer system or tablets, or we may say that over internet facilities, over video calls. These are all examples of ICT tools. If I am saying ICT plays a major role in agriculture, then by exploring the internet, the farmers can find out what is the current strategy in the market, what is the price of the crop, how they can generate their revenue, how they can protect their crops, means number of options or number of precautions are available where they can help, where they can find out the strategies that how they can help in growing their business. So firstly, we will discuss ICT information play a key role in improving agriculture production and value chain. If I'm saying food traceability, that means how much risk is concerned if a person is going with a particular food or particular crop. That means, is there any benefit to grow that particular crop, or the person may face loss in that business. Then ICT-enabled marketing and access to market play major role, especially for information on market prices. As I told you, that the crop prices, what is the up and down in the market, all information can be gathered by using the ICT tools. Even the international market information can be assessed by using the ICT tool. As smart devices are available to every person, so they can use it and explore over the agriculture. Then e-agriculture strategies in ICT policies. First is the online learning. Open online courses and their combination with scientific and educational content, which is most widely available, enabled an increased flow of new information and learning to smallholder farmers. Online learning also make it possible to monitor the capacity of institutes and communities to use this information effectively. As if there is some shortcoming at some place that one person can't go for physical education, then online courses are available related to that particular agriculture subject where they can enhance their knowledge and it may help in their business. Even the farmers who are not able to go physically at somewhere, they can gain knowledge by using the online learning tools. Then is growing use of big open real-time data collection and analysis. This is leading to innovative application for farm management and decision support, but also raising issues of intellectual asset management, particularly when data are collected at the farm level. Equally applicable to local adaptation of content is the approach based on content co-generation, which in turn raises issue of governance of data, information, skills and technology, and development of open standards and technology. As we are concerned with data collection and analysis, that there are some management techniques are there. They are working at their farm level where they can use your information and skill, which is helping developing various standards, that this is a particular standard. If a person want to achieve that standard, then he has to fulfill all the condition. All the condition has been mentioned, then only that one particular standard will be get delivered to that person. For example, if there is one ISO mark is there. ISO mark means if any product is applicable for ISO mark, then he has to pass that particular condition. Similarly, in the case of agriculture, some standards have been set on. Then to achieve that standard, what are the requirements are there? These can be assessed by using the ICT or e-agriculture. Then there are some challenges in this field: adaptation, capacity, gender and diversity, assessing participation, partnership, then technologies. First comes the adaptation. Adaptation of content to local needs, languages and context remain challenging. It means appropriate information resources, that is content and trusted intermediaries, are necessary for the success of e-agriculture initiative. Sometimes the intermediates are not available at that optimal level, so that they cannot achieve the success. Dissemination of information may be constrained if the nature of the information does not match farmers' need in terms of format and relevance. Suppose a farmer is going to find out something, but he has not going to going a particular we may say that information. Some other key, the farmer is going with some other keyword, but information is related to some other keyword. So it could be possible that no proper information can be gathered by farmer. While ICT can deliver large amount of information, this does not imply effective use of it. Locally adapted context and existing relationship based on trust are not yet sufficient attention and priority in development plans. Bringing ICT and development planning closer together with information innovations coming directly from the rural community themselves. Remaining an often overlooked design consideration in meeting the demands of the poorest communities. It doesn't mean that if I'm talking about ICT, it is only for the urban communities. Basically, ICT has been developed. What type of strategy should be there? What type of planning should be there? What kind of information should be there? All has been set up by relating to the rural communities, that they must gain their knowledge. Then the capacity. This is comprised of three dimensions: the enabling environment, the organizational capacity, the individual capacity. Capacity at the individual, organizational, and institute level need to be strengthened. The focus on improving access to agriculture information without addressing the ability to effectively use the information has not yet yielded the desired reduction of the rural digital divide. Illiteracy, limited skill in using the complex devices to search for information, and cultural issues remain barrier to effectively receiving and using information delivered via ICT. As some people are not so much educated that they can assess the proper information, or they can use the English for the search work. So some facilities have been still provided that they can use their own language tools to search something, but still it is complex behavior that there is some barrier is there between the ICT tools and the rural communities. Then the gender and diversity. Access and opportunities are not distributed equally among users, creating asymmetries that may be addressed, that must be addressed with specific policies targeting the source of inequalities. That means some policies has been set up which cover the gap between the inequalities. Access for women, youth, older farmers, and people living in most remote areas is hindered by the price of access of ICT. As we are saying that rural area is there, definitely the poverty is there, the people are not able to afford the devices, then how they can access the devices? If they are not able to afford it, then they can't access it. Gender inequality remains a serious issue in the digital economy, as does the gap between the urban and the rural population. as in the urban population, there is no gender inequality, but in the rural population, there is a huge gap between a male personality and a female personality. So it is also a major issue. Access and participation. Removed access to ICT alone will not resolve the digital divide, gender digital divide. As with the challenges reported in other key areas, proper design and implementation based on the bottom-up and participatory approach that involves the community themselves can reduce the potential for information inequality that can be considered when introducing new ICT into the community. It says, it is not like the gender is the only barrier. How they can assess and participate in using a particular information when new ICT approach is going to be launched, it must be informed priorly to all the communities. Then the partnership. Public-private partnerships are recognized as a critical factor in sustainable business models as the community level, but these two not always have to be with the large corporate firms, small local private companies, local producer organization, and community-based NGOs. Open and this social capital to provide trusted information and good quality services. It is the moral responsibility of any organization if they are providing any sort of facility, they must provide some trusted information. They must not misguide the farmers or the rural community, and they always provide quality service. Diverse advisory and extension services offered by different type of providers are more likely to meet the various needs of the farmers, as there is no one type of advisory service that can fit all circumstances. As some advices are provided, it is not that all problem will be resolved with single advice. For if you are having 10 problems, then 10 advices are required for your 10 problems. It is written that each problem will be handled at different level. With the broader range of potential partners comes a new challenge. The formal recognition of information and service quality standards and partners agreement to be held accountable for meeting them. Then the technologies. Technologies should be suitable to local context and needs. Their selection should increasingly take into account the influence ICT have on gender and social dynamics. It is like if technology has been used, then it must be taken into consideration that the context and need will be at the priority level. That why we are going to launch it. The appropriation of ICT by youth in support of farming activities is also creating shift in the social dynamics between youth and older community members or between rural and urban communities. Then there are some computer models that are used for the plant processing. The models are depending upon the purpose. The models have been classified. That is statistical model, mechanistic model, deterministic model, stochastic model, dynamic model, static model, simulation model, descriptive model, and explanatory model. Coming to the first type, statistical model, this model expresses the relationship between yield or yield component and weather parameter. That is yield component and weather parameter. In this model, relationship is merged by using the statistical techniques. Example, step down regression and correlation. In this, some mathematical relationship have been used where you can calculate the component like yield and weather parameters. Then the mechanistic model. In this model, it will not only explain the weather parameter and the yield, but also the mechanism of this model. These models are on physical selection. That means what is the outlook is there, mechanical outlook is there, designing part is there, the relationship is with the mechanistic model. If the mathematical approach is there, that is with the statistical model. Then the deterministic model. This model estimates the exact value of the yield and dependent variables. some variables are there that are depending upon each other. These models also have some defined coefficients. Stochastic model. In this model, it is attached to the output. For each set of input, different outputs are given along with probabilities. These models define yield or state of dependent variable at given rates. Then the dynamic model. Time is included as a variable. Both dependent and independent variables are having some values which remain constant over a given period of time. Then the static model. Time is not included in the variable. As a variable, dependent and independent variable have remained fixed constant value over a given period of time. The main question can be asked here is, what is the difference between dynamic model and static model? As the word dynamic is concerned, the value varies, it will not remain constant. There are some variables whose value remain vary. But in the static model, whatsoever the variable and parameters are used here will remain constant at a given period of time. Then the simulation model. In this model, a mathematical representation of a real world system. One of the main goal of crop simulation model is to estimate agriculture production as a function of weather and soil condition as well as crop management is concerned. These models are used different differential equation, calculate both rate and static variable over time. Normally for planting until harvest maturity or the final maturity is there. Then comes the descriptive model. A descriptive model defines behavior of system in a simple manner. This model reflects little or none of the mechanism that are causes of the phenomena, but consists of one or more mathematical equation. An example of such equation is one derived from successfully measured weight of the crops. The equation is helpful to determine quickly the weight of the crop where no observation was made. As means the description is concerned, where not such mathematical tools are used, simply one or two equations is concerned with the descriptive model. Explanatory model. This consists of quantitative description of the mechanism and process that causes the behavior of the system. To create this model, a system is analyzed and its process and mechanism are quantified separately. The model is built by integrating these description for the entire system. That means a whole description is there that is concerned in the explanatory model.